Bismillah, wassalatu wassalam ala rasulullahi wa ba'd. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of you. Jazakumullah khairan. Thank you so much for joining us for this seventh episode of the miraculous night journey of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, we left it in episode 6 where the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam majestically led all of the prophets, all of those who had what's called in the Quran the mithaq al-nabiyyin. There was a covenant between all of the prophets in the other world, the world of the unseen, before they were even sent here, in the alam al-arwah, the world of the souls, where all of the prophets were gathered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they bore witness that they would support and believe in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we see this beautifully manifested on the night journey of the ascension that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam leads all of the prophets alayhi wasalam in salah, and there is conversations between them about what will yet to come, and the likes of the signs of the hour. Isa alayhi salam will provide information, because he is of course the Rasul, the Messenger alayhi salam, who will come near the end of time and of course kill the Dajjal at the eastern gate of Bab Lud, outside of the holy city of Jerusalem. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he then says, and we saw also previously, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam meets Malik, the guardian angel of hellfire, who is the first one, subhanAllah, of other to begin by saying, sending salams on the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasalam. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam then says, ثُمَّ خَرَجْتُ فَجَاءَنِي جِبْرِيلِ, that I left from the holy Masjid al-Aqsa, came out of the Masjid. And just to be clear, this is where when you look at Masjid al-Aqsa, it's the whole rectangular haram. At the front of it, towards the Qibla, it's called the al-Masjid al-Qibli. This was the original, certainly in the Islamic era, it was Umar radiallahu anhu who built a wooden structure which could house about 3,000 Muslims in that area of the Qibli Masjid. And that's where it's believed that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he led all the other prophets in prayer. It's then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam leaves from this area. And I should also mention that at that time, sorry to say, the Romans were actually using the area as a rubbish dump, and they had banished all Jews from the area, and almost as punishment to them, they desecrated their holy site of Masjid al-Aqsa al-Mubarak, and actually Umar radiallahu anhu, who himself will clear the area alongside the companions who come victoriously into Bayt al-Maqdis, alhamdulillah. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam exits, and he says that he was brought bi-ina'in min khamar wa ina'in min laban, that he was brought a vessel of khamar, of wine. And remember, at this time, wine has not been prohibited. This is 1 year before the hijrah. The prohibition of wine takes place after the hijrah in Medina and Munawwara. And he's also brought a vessel of laban, of milk. And some also add to it water and honey in other riwayas, and Allah knows best. فَاخْتَرْتُ laban. And he was given the choice, and he said, I selected immediately the milk. And Jibreel alayhi salam, he said, اخترت الفطرة, you have chosen the natural state, subhanAllah. And أصبت الفطرة, and again in other riwayas it says that had you chosen wine, your ummah would have gone astray, subhanAllah. So here we see a critical moment during the night journey and the ascension that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, on our behalf, and we thank Allah and love Allah and his Messenger alayhi salam, that our ummah was guided on the correct choice of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam at this point. You know, we get to an amazing occasion now that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and the scholars will say the dominant position is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam then moved to the what's called As-Sakhra al-Musharrafa. He moved to the noble rock, which is in the center of the Haram of Masjid al-Aqsa Mubarak, where today sits or stands the Qubbat al-Sakhra, the Masjid of the Qubbat al-Sakhra, the Dome of the Rock. Above this rock, honoring this rock, this Masjid sits there. And it's at this rock the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is ascended into the heavens, and in riwayas we have Jibreel alayhi salam takes the blessed hand of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam and then ascends into the heavens. So just to be clear, the scholars are of the opinion, based on the ahadith literature we have, that Buraq is not with them on this part of the journey. Buraq remains tied at the gatepost on the western wall of Masjid al-Aqsa al-Mubarak, and it's actually Jibreel alayhi salam, who is not in his full angelic form, we'll talk about later on in later episodes, but in the form of a beautiful man, and Allah knows best, is with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam at the Sakhra Musharrafa. And now we need to clarify, as we clarify the word al-Isra, it means to journey by night, yani safar bil layl. This mi'raj in Arabic is what's called in Arabic, in etymology, it's called in sarf, in morphology, it's called ismul ala, it's called the noun of instrument. Mi'raj literally means a means for you to uruj, means for you to ascend upwards. So then there's a question about what that was, and Allah knows best. However, we do have riwayas which say that the mi'raj was a ladder, okay, a staircase. You could arguably use the elevator, but probably not. That had gold and silver alternating steps in line with the different layers of Jannah that also have gold and silver interlacing levels. And that its banisters, its side rails, were encrusted with pearls. And that either side of this mi'raj, this divine ladder, which by the way, to be clear, descended from Jannatul Firdaus, the highest level of Jannah, to the Sakhra, to the blessed rock in the heart of Masjid al-Aqsa Mubarak, is surrounded by angels, Hammadun, that are praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly. Allahu Akbar, what a scene. Jibreel alayhi salam takes the blessed hand of the Prophet alayhi salam, and then thumma araja bina ila sama, that the Prophet alayhi salam and Jibreel alayhi salam will ascend into the heavens. And just to clarify what we mean by heavens here, we mean by the sky firmaments. We don't mean paradise, we mean the layers of sky. And so the scholars want to make mention of this, that this is so the Prophet ﷺ will get to what's called as-sama ad-dunya. He will go to what is called the lower sky. How we would term it in modern English, we'd say it's the end of the known universe. This is the end of the known universe that the Prophet ﷺ will now go ascend into the heavens, and he will go to a point what's called Bab al-Hafada. And to be clear, this is directly above Masjid al-Aqsa Mubarak, and specifically the Dome of the Rock. Literally, they ascend straight up on this mi'raj into the heavens, into the layers of the sky. On the way, they actually pass, there's two Ismail alayhi salam, two angels are called Ismail alayhi salam. One is the gatekeeper of the lower sky, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about, as-sama ad-dunya, zayyana as-sama ad-dunya bi masabiha, that we have adorned the lower sky, the end of the known universe, with its adorned it, beautified it with lamps, meaning the Nujum, the stars, and Allah knows best, and the constellations, and how beautiful the sky is, subhanAllah, the night sky, subhanAllah, and the universe, Allahu Akbar. And then it goes on to say, there was another angel, Ismail, and they said Ismail alayhi salam hadn't descended to the earth or neither into the heavens. He was somewhere in the interspace between the two. And they said the only time, subhanAllah, he descended is at the passing of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he heard this cry. And it was the angel of death, the Malakul Maut, subhanAllah, that cried as he took the soul of the Messenger of Allah. So what an emotional, Ya Allah, emotional time. Ismail Islam, the angel, actually descends at hearing this, at the passing of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. At this point, of course, the Prophet is alive and well. And then they go to the face. And it's so beautiful, the seekers, and we're going to see this repeated now, as the Prophet ﷺ ascends into the different layers of the sky. That it says, فَاسْتَفْتَحَ جِبْرَيْلِ, that Jibreel ﷺ, he sought permission to enter. So he, as if, like he knocked on that Bab al-Hafada, the gateway of protection directly above the Dome of the Rock. The angel, and this is Ismail ﷺ now, the gatekeeper of the first layer of the sky, says, مَنْ أَنْتَ, who are you? Now you might say, hold on a minute, this is the angel Ismail alayhi salam. Surely he recognizes one of the archangels Gabriel, Jibreel alayhi salam. What they say is, it's a really interesting point, they say, like Waraqa ibn Nawfal radiallahu anhu and others, that Jibreel alayhi salam is a shapeshifter, tashakkul, he changes shape and shifts appearance, right? So, and Namus al-Akbar, he's referred to by Waraqa ibn Nawfal, that he's like the greatest spy of good. So he shapeshifts. So the angel is just clarifying, man anta, who are you? He says, qala Jibreel. He says, it's Gabriel. And he says, qila wa man ma'ak, and who's with you? He said, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qila wa qad bu'itha ilay. Has he really been, and in other riwayas it's ursila ilay, like has he been sent, is this the time, has the time finally come, because now the angels of these heavens are now going to experience coming into the presence, the blessed presence of the greatest creation of Allah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There's incredible excitedness. Qala qad bu'itha ilay, he said, yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent for him. And this is like, now you know, angels can't lie. So just to be clear, yafa'aluna ma yu'marun, they do as they're commanded to do. So there isn't, the angel is not saying, oh, can you give proof of this or whatever? No, his word is the truth. And it's then it says, وَفُتِحَ لَنَا, and that the gateway, Bab al-Hafadha, it opened for us. And inshallah, in the next episode, we'll mention the reaction of the angel Ismail alayhi salam and who the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam will meet first in the first layer of the sky. Jazakallah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.